Hello, this is Brian Klein with Thunderhead Engineering. Today I'd like to give you a short tutorial on how to use a combination of behaviors and exit selection within those behaviors assigned to different occupant groups to specify distributions of exit goals across different occupant groups. So I've set up a very basic case. I have a small room with two doors, a left and a right door, as you can see here, and then I have a larger room that surrounds that room that has four exit doors, and there's top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right. So these two rooms, I will have different occupant groups in the two rooms. I'll have an inner group and an outer group, and then within each of these occupant groups I will assign different percentages of behaviors to the group so that they won't all try to achieve the same take any exit or go to any exit behavior that is the default behavior of the simulation. So in this case, I want to create four behaviors. The first behavior will be to take either this exit, the top left, or the bottom right exit. The second behavior will be the bottom left and the top right. The third behavior will be either one of these front two exits, and the fourth behavior is to take any exit. That's the default behavior. So, let's get started. First behavior, you right-click and add a behavior. I'm going to call this upper left dash lower right. Okay, so that's our first assignment. And what I want with this one is I'm not going to use any of these behaviors for waypoints or rooms, elevators, or weight, and it won't have any initial delay, but I do want to modify this exits. By default, it's to any. So what I want to do is switch this to choose, and then I want the upper left and bottom right, and say OK. All right, so these two exits are now assigned to this one. We'll do this again. Add behavior. We're going to call this let's do upper right, lower left. Okay. And we'll do the same thing here. Choose. And we want bottom left and top right. Okay. Then the next behavior is, we'll just call this the left side, left exits. So we want a new behavior, left exits. And it does help to name. I mean, if you look at I named all of the exits in here, so it made it easy to find. If not, it'll just be like exit 1, exit 2, exit 3, exit 4. It'll number them. It's difficult to know, you know, when you're looking at the exit selection window like here, what exit was what. You'd have to go look at the model, and especially if you have very large models with, you know, tens or in some cases hundreds of exits, it definitely saves time. You know, to name them so you can just see directly in this list. But I want the top left and the bottom left here. It's my two left exits, and then I have the go to any exit, which is the default behavior. Okay, so now that I have my behaviors created, I'm going to create my occupant groups now. So in the first room here, I'll just right click, I'll add occupants, and I'll put 20 individuals in here. And for the behavior here, I'm going to modify this. And so when you modify the behavior selection in this add occupants window, 100% is assigned to the go to any exit. So for this inner group, I don't want any of them just to take any exit. I want to be a little bit more specific. And in this case, I want, we'll say 70% to take the left exits. And we'll say that 30% of them know about this lower right exit. So in that, the upper left is there, but they can also take this. So there's a 30% distribution across this group. And it tells me down here that I have 100% assigned. So this is nice just to double check. You could click distribute evenly, and in here 25% would be assigned to across these four behaviors, but I don't want that for this case. So I'll say OK, and it tells me here I have 70% left exits and 30% upper left, lower right. I want them randomly distributed inside of this area, and I want 20. So say OK. And there I have 20 occupants. And you'll notice that they're selected here, and the behavior is a blank. This means that it's basically has multiple assignments. So there's not a specific behavior assigned to the group. If I come in here and look at the occupant group and I go to a particular individual, I can see that this one is assigned left exits. Up. So you can mount down through just I'm arrowing down and I'm looking at the behavior that's set right here, and I can see as I move down through which exit behavior is assigned to the group. And so the next group will be in this area. I'll add occupants here. Now it keeps the same behavior, that persists, and so you'll want to modify that or else we'll have the same exact behavior. And so I'll click on this, and in this case I'm going to say 10% can go to any exit. We'll say 20% takes the left exits, and then let's do 10 to the upper left, lower right, and the last 60 to the upper right, lower left. So that'll be this group. So most of the people here, the majority should take this, either this exit or this exit. The rest will be distributed across. So I say OK, and I'm going to put 50 people in this area. So I have 50 individuals here. If I click on my occupants, I can see that my total count is 70. I have two groups. You can right-click and rename these. So I'll call this inner room, and I'll rename this one to outer room. It's good practice to name as many of your components as possible. It just makes referencing a lot easier. So I have four behaviors. I have two occupant groups, and I have the geometry as I've specified before. So we'll save this model, and call this exit behaviors, and we'll go ahead and run this. So it's finished with the simulation. Let me just resize this window a little bit here. Okay. So we have our results, and we can move this around in the 3D view, and we'll take a look. We see there's a little bit more crowding here, but people changed the queue. Even though his shortest path might have been to go this way originally, after switching the inner queue to the left side, we'll rewind this. After changing his idea here, so we'll watch this one individual, and we'll look at their path. So we see it started to make a movement to the left door, to the right door, back to the left door. It's trying to find the fastest way out of this room, finds it to the left, and then this lower left option still meets one of the exit criteria for that individual. We'll take a look at another occupant. Let's see if I can find one here. Okay. Let's see. Here we go. All right. So this individual starts out in the main room and begins to make a left exit through this door, which seems to be shorter, makes a changes path, comes out, and goes through this way. Take a look at just some of these other examples here. These people are trying to find the fastest way out of their local room while still achieving their goal, their exit goal. And we can correlate, let's stop this, and I'll take a look at this individual. Let me reset the view. So I know that it's this occupant here that I'm interested in. So let's take a look then. It should be this occupant, I believe. Yes. So if we look at her options, it's any of the left exits. Okay. So let's go back here and watch what she does. So she starts to the left because it's closer, but there's more people queued at this door. So she waits here, is trying to get through, it's too much jamming, switches to this more open door, and then takes one of the left exits. So you can see that this pathing behavior is pretty dynamic. She's making decisions to try to get out of this inner room as quickly as possible, not necessarily through the shortest path. The first move is shortest, sees a queue greater than the queue to this door, since the majority of people are going to be heading to the left side. And you can see that in the line density too, that there's more tracks on the left than the right. And then takes the exit. So that's basically the behavior and exit selection setup. If you have any questions about setting up behaviors or how to assign exit selection to your occupant groups, please send an email to support@thunderheading.com, and we'll be happy to help you with that. Thank you.